Thank you, Dr. Radhika. This, as Dr. Radhika mentioned, this course has been going on since the last 2-3 years, curated by Dr. Rishi Mohan, and number one. Right at the outset, sometimes dry eye is quite obvious, but sometimes we have trouble in diagnosing if there's a little red eye. What is exactly troubling the patient? Is it allergy? Is it infection? Is it dryness? Or is it some sort of combination of two of the three or all three, which can all happen? So sometimes some cases are a little confusing. So the idea of this small presentation is to see if we can lessen the confusion here. So when there are classical features of, say, allergy with large papillae on the bulbar conjunctiva, on the palpable conjunctiva, on the bulbar conjunctiva, Tranter's dots, things like this, there is you don't need a slit lamp, you don't need anything else. Patient says, I'm complaining of itching, and you look at the patient and he's got this picture, or he could have a shield ulcer, and you evert the lid and you got papillae there, and you treat the patient for allergy. Infections, if there is a mucopurulent discharge from the eye, conjunctival congestion away from the limbal area, usually a bilateral case, there's an epidemic going on in the city, it could be viral. If there is a lot of pus, it could be bacterial. Most cases it is viral, but these again are fairly easy to diagnose, that this is pure infection, and you can treat the patient preferably with no steroids, with just the mild anti-infectives to just keep it, prevent secondary bacterial infection. If they're viral, just using lubricant drops and some cold compresses would do the trick. And you get sometimes classical dry eye, patients coming to you with blinking disorders because of computer vision syndrome, a small filamentary keratitis, mucus at the canthus, squamous blepharitis, meibomitis. You can, if you want, do staining, tumor strips, and reduce TBUT, and you know that this is purely a case of dryness. So these are the classical appearance of these three conditions. But sometimes there is a confusion. What if there is allergy and dry eye? Can it happen? Yes. Child comes to you with years of allergy, anti-allergic treatment, all sorts of medicines have been put in the eye. Because of the allergy itself, he can develop dryness. Because of the medications and their preservatives, he can develop dryness. How will you diagnose that there is a superadded dryness to the allergy? Because otherwise, you will only treat the allergy and you will miss this, and the patient will not be completely all right. So go for a careful history. Is the patient feeling any burning sensation? He's got sandy particle sensation. He's got itching in the eye. Is there also a burning sensation? Ask for it, because it's the children. They will not volunteer everything. Their vocabulary is not so great. But ask them whether they complain. Ask the parents if they sometimes tell the parents that there is a burning sensation in the eye. That's a dead giveaway that along with the allergy, there is some amount of dryness there. If you suspect this, especially in long-standing allergies, give a therapeutic trial. Add preservative-free lubricants to the allergy treatment. Is the patient significantly better? If the patient is significantly better by adding the lubricant, it's a therapeutic trial telling you that there is a superadded dry eye and you need to take care of this as well. Tips to prevent, what about, as I told you, in conjunctival infections, you can get dry eye. You can get medicamentosa because we tend to over-treat conjunctival infections. So we talked about allergy and dry eye. Now this is infections which can cause dry eye. Please understand that most cases are viral, do not need topical antibiotics. Many times I've seen patient goes to Dr. A. Our patients also don't have patients anymore because they have Google with them. So they go to Dr. A, who prescribes, say, the ciprofloxacin 4 times a day. And then in 2 days, they're not completely all right. So they go to Dr. B, who says ciprofloxacin is old-fashioned. I'll give you something higher. And he goes to moxifloxacin. And then he goes to Dr. C, who says moxifloxacin is not so broad spectrum. I'll give you 0.5% getifloxacin and higher strength, and so on. So he comes with a bag full of drops. Then the fourth guy says, well, all antibiotics have been tried, he's not better still. Let me add some steroid to it. So he gives steroid antibiotic drops and so on. So the cycle perpetuates. So if an infection of the conjunctiva, I mention infection like this because again, most of these are viral, which are self-limiting. You just need to reassure the patient, cold compresses and lubricants is all that it needs. But if the patient has been treated for a week or 10 days and it has either worsened after initial treatment or it has not improved, suspect conjunctivitis medicamentosa because of abuse of the antibiotics, or even sometimes keratitis medicamentosa can occur. What is the therapeutic trial for this? Stop the antibiotic drops. 10 days he has been on all sorts of medicines. Stop them all. Replace with non-preserved lubricants. Frequent use. Patient should feel better within 48 hours. And then if the patient is completely better, then very gingerly you can add surface acting steroids to reduce the inflammation, because a purely inflammatory process which has occurred as a result of abuse of the antibiotics. So this is a patient whom I had, who had some amount of chemosis as well. So this angry red eye was like this, waxing and waning since the last 15 days on all sorts of treatment. Symptoms typically of conjunctivitis or keratitis medicamentosa: initial improvement in the original condition, then apparent deterioration. When the usual symptoms with redness, lid swelling, blurred vision, you can even get chemosis as I showed you. And if it becomes keratitis medicamentosa, then you can even get punctate staining, chronic epithelial defects. Sometimes there is some allergic component like this, you get an allergic dermatitis type of picture. But otherwise you just get something like, it looks like a chronic conjunctivitis which is not improving. So there should be nothing like a chronic conjunctivitis which is not improving. So just stop antibiotics, add lubricants, and the patient usually is better. So infection and dry eye tips. Many assume that all patients, now I'm talking about now patient of dry eye, can he not get infected? Yes, he can. Sometimes what happens, you have a patient of dry eye for years, you've been treating him with different medicines and keeping him going, in the sense that he continues to pay consultation fee regularly every few months that you call him, and you are happy, patient is happy. Suddenly the patient feels that his symptoms are worsened, he calls you up. Now he's been your patient for 5 years, you know he's a patient of dry eye, he calls you up and he says, I'm feeling worse. You tell him, put the drops more often, every hourly you put the drops now. He was putting it 5 times a day, now put it every hour, because you assume that a dry eye patient can only get waxing and many of dry eye, nothing else can happen, which is not true. Dry eye patients are prone to infections because the ocular surface is compromised. So avoid telephonic treatment and look for coexisting blepharitis. Usually when a dry eye patient becomes worse, there is a blepharitis component which has worsened. So call the patient in, look for meibomitis, look for squamous blepharitis. Unless you aggressively treat that and just increase the frequency of the drops, he is not going to get better. So a known dry eye patient presenting with conjunctivitis is not uncommon. However, don't overdo antibiotics, because these patients can go into dry complications and become worse dry eye much easier. So topical antibiotics, especially aminoglycosides, are toxic. What are aminoglycosides? Your topramycin and your gentamicin. They're toxic to the surface and can worsen a dry eye. So treat aggressively for a week or so and abruptly stop antibiotics. There is no such thing in the world as tapering of antibiotics. There is only stop. Antibiotics can never be tapered. Steroids must be tapered. So these are some take-home messages. And continue the lubricants even when the antibiotics are on. So in spite of antibiotics, please continue the lubricants, because basically he is your patient of dry eye. Then the other combination, allergy and infection, can they occur? So we talked about allergy and dry eye, we talked about infection and dry eye. Now allergy and infection, the other combination, can it occur? Yes. Who are our prime allergy patients? These kind of kids. Kids go around, run in the sand, run in the mud, and the hygiene is not the world's best hygiene. So they often rub their eyes with dirty fingers because they got itching. So there is no reason why they can't get infection. Suspect coexisting infection on phone. If parents tell you the eye discharge is different, what will the parents tell you? Because sir, he used to get a little watery discharge with the itching, but now there is a little mucopurulent discharge. Nowadays we've got phone pictures on WhatsApp. The IMA doesn't encourage this. Sometimes you can't help it. So ask them to send a picture and then call the patient over. Don't prescribe on the phone. So treat as coexisting infection if besides the papillae, the rest of the conjunctiva is red or inflamed. In an allergic eye, you don't get the whole eye inflamed ever. So you can give a short course of frequent topical antibiotics. Most important is let the allergy treatment continue. So this is combination of allergy and infection. So avoid aggressive steroid therapy in diagnostic dilemmas. So sometimes, as I said, you can get allergy with infection, allergy with dry eye with infection. All these combinations can occur, but careful history taking, using your ears and putting the patient in front of you and examining him, you'll come to know which of the two or the three or all three are present. Don't do shotgun therapy with steroids, which most people are wanting to do, because steroids will suppress everything. Then we'll see after a week. So they only suppress the symptoms and sometimes result in new infections on stoppage. So avoid this shotgun therapy. I've seen patients on anti-infectives, antifungals, antivirals, antibiotics, everything. So they are a sure recipe for conjunctivitis medicamentosa. This patient is going to land up with problems. So to conclude, allergy plus dry eye, infection plus dry eye, allergy plus infection can coexist. Learn to recognize and treat. Avoid telephonic diagnosis and treatment of chronic dry eye patients or chronic allergy patients. Don't overdo anti-infective treatment. 1 week is max. Don't taper topical antibiotics and beware all the time of conjunctivitis medicamentosa. Thank you so much.